So almost 3 years ago, I showed you how to stick text to a moving object in DaVinci Resolve, right? But since then, we've moved from DaVinci Resolve 18 to 19. Some things have changed, and some of you are confused now, which is totally understandable, of course. And so in this video, I want to show you all the options for sticking text to a moving object in DaVinci Resolve 19, Studio, and the free version. And I'm going to show you how to do it with animated text, and I'm going to show you how to do it with multiple trackers. All of that in one video. Here we go. And the workflow is actually pretty much exactly the same in both the free and studio version of DaVinci Resolve. But in the studio version, you get an extra option, an extra feature. Let me show you. So this is my video clip, right? And the first thing you need to do is make sure that the playhead is over the video clip and then go to the Fusion page. And then in the Fusion page, with the Media In node selected, that's this node, hit Shift plus Spacebar and look for the tracker. Add it. And it should connect automatically between the Media In and Out node. If not, just connect it manually by click and dragging these little squares. See? Okay, now, here's where it sometimes gets confusing, because in DaVinci Resolve 19 Studio, you have the option to choose the new IntelliTracker or the old Point Tracker. And I guess the difference between the Point Tracker and the IntelliTracker is that the IntelliTracker uses AI or some other kind of magic to track an object, and the Point Tracker is just some older technology. But that doesn't mean that the IntelliTracker will always give you the best result. But the IntelliTracker usually does a great job, and it's easier to use. That's the main difference. But if you're on the free version of Resolve and you only have the Point Tracker, don't worry, because you can almost always get the same result with the Point Tracker. I'll show you both. So first, if you're on the studio version and you want to use the IntelliTracker, you don't have to do anything because it's the one that pops up by default. See, this is the IntelliTracker box. And all you need to do is put the tracker box over the object you want to track and then just hit track. And if you want to use the Point Tracker, then you can just add a Point Tracker here and then just delete the IntelliTracker. And the Point Tracker is the only option in the free version of Resolve. So it's the one that pops up by default in the free version. You can't use the IntelliTracker. And how this works is, first you put the tracker box over the object you want to track, and then you can adjust the outer box here. And that outer box basically tells Resolve in what area it has to look for the object. Now, how big you make that box depends on the shape and size of the object, also how fast it moves, how much contrast there is. So you're gonna have to play around with it to find out what will give you the best result. And then, same as before, just hit track and let Resolve track the object. And then, regardless of if you use the Intelli or Point Tracker, select the tracker node, go to operation mode and set it to match move. Then make sure to deselect the tracker node and add a text node here and connect it like this. And then just type your text here. And that's it. The text will now follow the tracked object. But what if you want to stick an animated title to a moving object? Well, it might seem like it doesn't work with the workflow I showed you, but it does. There's just one thing you need to do. So in the edit page, right-click on your video clip and create a fusion clip. And then just follow the exact same steps I showed you. But then, of course, instead of adding a text node, you go to the Effects tab here, look for the animated title you want to use, and connect it to the tracker node. And guys, of course you could use the DaVinci Resolve built-in animated titles. They're pretty good, but there's also this guy who has a Motion VFX plugin with effects, animated titles, motion graphics. Looks super cool, and he seems to be a super nice, awesome, incredibly handsome and intelligent man. So, I mean, maybe go check it out. I'll put his link in the description. And what if you want to use multiple trackers? Well, you can actually add multiple trackers in one tracker node, and you could use these different trackers to then stick text to different objects, but I find it a lot easier to just add another tracker node. So we have one tracker node here, right, with some text? Well, just add a second tracker node here, and then follow the exact same steps from before. Simple. Okay, and then finally, what if you don't get a good tracking result because the object moves too fast, or there's not enough contrast, or I don't know, whatever reason. First of all, you could try using these tracker settings here to increase the contrast of your image. So you can tell Resolve to For example, just use the red channel or the green channel and see how it changes the contrast. So just try it out and use the option that gives you the best contrast between the object you want to track and the background. One of these might give you a better result. But if that doesn't work, I dropped a video a few weeks ago in which I show you how you can manually adjust and tweak the tracker path. The link is in the description. And it's super easy, so just go check it out. And that's it. I hope it cleared up some of the confusion now that we moved from DaVinci Resolve 18 to 19. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.